I don't even know where to begin. The beauty industry has disappointed me completely this week. I took my time. I wrote a letter. For those of you guys wanting to see the letter, my Instagram feed, the letter's posted. And I send it out to all the brands that I have supported over the last 10 years, perhaps. I've used these brands. I've supported these brands. And some replied. And the reply was, needless to say, generic. The one that's like actually eye-opening are the ones that are choosing to stay silent. And some of them, Tarte, for example, chose to take me off their Twitter feed and direct me to their DM, giving me their email address to contact them. I emailed them. No one responded. Like, our money is good for you, but our color isn't. We are asking that you guys diversify your feed. Like, use not only Caucasian creatives. They're not the only ones bringing money. We, Black creatives, we make our content. We share our content. We share the products that we're using, which is your product. And now when we need you the most to stand with us, you guys are choosing to be quiet. Key from Australia. You guys know Key. Just silent. I actually thought they were going to say something. They were going to email, like respond, saying something. But it's funny how they take Black creative that has the most following and they use them for their advantage. I.e. Key is using Lizzo, and you want them for clout. You want them for the following. But when we're asking you to diversify your feed, somebody took their time to email you. You're choosing just to be complacent? Limecrime decided to send me an email saying that they're extending their PR list and I should send my information to them. So now that makes me wonder, do you think that Black creatives are just about a handout? We just want freebies? That's why we're contacting you guys? No, like legit, we're talented. We are just as talented as our Caucasian counterparts, but we're just not being acknowledged. That's all. We pay for your product, but we're not being acknowledged. Now, one company in particular, their reply was actually, I thought they were being completely genuine. I felt it was genuine, which is Ipsy. Now, saying something and actually doing something are two totally different things, but I applaud them for their reply completely. And I also want to urge Beautycon, Ipsy, to be very, very selective in who you guys are choosing to be your vendors at these shows. There are little girls coming in, the next generation of creatives are coming in. Do you want the message to be? Do you want it to be that you do not matter because you're everything else besides white? People spend their hard-earned money to come to these shows, to buy these products. Education is free. Like, you can literally go on Google right now and Google anything and everything. Wrong is wrong is wrong is wrong. So that's all we're asking you guys to do, is diversify your feed. Work with Black creatives. Include us in campaigns. Include us in your ads. It's not much. We're not asking for much. We're just asking for equality. I implore you, after listening to this message, to do what's right. Thank you.